Hello, my lovely students. A very, very warm welcome to all of you. So, my atoms, I hope you know and you are very well aware about the series called as VIP series and what exactly is this very important questions of a particular chapter we are going to discuss. Every chapter we are going to divide in a dependable number of sessions so that whenever you really want to revise, you can see these videos. Super, super helpful, and you'll automatically going to say, yeah ma'am, the chapter is done, the revision is done, most probable questions that can come in exams, that's also done, and we are super prepared, and 90% target for us is like easy peasy. So if you want to have the same confidence, do not forget to follow this. And this is the third session where we are going to discuss about our corrosion, our rancidity, our redox reactions in detail. So chemical reactions and equations, third session with your Anubha ma'am. I'm going to start right now, so give me a quick high five. Do not forget to like, share, and definitely subscribe to this channel and give equal love that you have given to our previous 19th Hindi channel. Yes everyone, and you can always get the Vedanta Pro course. There's a link in the description box pinned by Vedanta 19th channel. Over there, you'll find a link. When you'll copy and you'll click on it, you'll see a proper page of Vedanta platform where you can get the courses of your class 10th standard. This is the best time because you can have all the crash courses, micro courses for full revision. But do not forget to apply the code AGE, English Channel Pro. That will give you 20 to 31% extra discount on MRP. And I know you want that because everyone loves discount, so am I. Okay everyone, let's start with the very first question. We'll discuss variety of questions, so please stay till the end. Revise with your Anubha ma'am. You can always have a notebook and pen and can solve it with me so that you'll get more and more confidence. Chemically, what exactly is rust? You have following options because you know that MCQs are very much important as the pattern of the exam is changed. So what is rust? Students generally get confused in A and B, or maybe C as well. First of all, you should know the formula of rust, Fe2O3.XH2O. You can always give your response in the comment section. I'll wait for it because as much as active you will become, you will see more and more growth in your confidence as well as in your score. Okay, so this is my rust. Yeah, everyone. So what will be the right answer? Ma'am, could be A, could be B, because high rated iron oxide, but iron valency actually matters because iron shows two type of valency, 2 and 3. And please do remember, two valency, lower valency we use us in the end, higher valency we end it with ick. So this is Fe2O3, means iron having a valency 3, oxygen having a valency 2, cross multiply will give exactly the valency as well. So this is hydrated ferric oxide, that means option number B. So anyone who didn't mark option number B, please make it right now, absolutely correct, that yeah, that was my mistake and now I got it. Yes everyone. Okay, on this note, we'll move ahead. You can always download the file with the elaborative answer as well as the correct answer. Next question is a substance which oxidizes itself and reduces other. You have to see what it is doing to the other substance, that will be the answer. So a substance that reduces other will be, I'll show you option, give me answer. Oxidizing agents, reducing agents, both A and B, none of these. I think a similar kind of a question I asked to my students, and you know what did they tell me? Ma'am, both A and B. And I was like, what? Like seriously? You know the special meme, what? Okay, so here, as I told you, the substance which will reduce other will be a reducing agent. To reduce the other substance, it has to oxidize itself. Okay, they'll do the opposite job to itself. Yeah, so the answer is nothing but reducing agent. I hope you have given the right answer. I'm hoping to. Let's move to the third one. Which of the following statements about the reaction below are incorrect? So you know what is oxidation and what is reduction? I can revise the topic too. And until then, you can always send your response in the comment section, chat section as well. Oxidation and reduction, what exactly is this? Oxidation. Asian means addition. Oxygen. So this is oxygen addition. and reduction is removal of something, definitely removal of oxygen. One concept that is needed to solve this. So the statement that you need to choose is incorrect one or are incorrect one. So first of all, without even looking at the option, I would suggest you to solve this, then look at the options. So less confusion will be there. If you'll automatically see the options, you will get more and more confusion. Oh, no, 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 this is the right. No, no, this one is the right. So don't do that. Just see that what my reactant is becoming on the product side. Lead oxide to lead means loss of oxygen, which is reduction, means lead oxide is reduced to lead, right? Or I can also say on the reverse side, lead was earlier lead oxide. Means if I see the reverse reaction, lead to lead oxide was oxidized. Lead oxidized to give lead oxide, or lead oxide reduced to lead. Okay, this point is clear. Carbon, carbon dioxide, oxygen addition, that's oxidation. So carbon is getting oxidized. Now look at the option 1, 2, 3, 4, what all are correct and incorrect. We need to choose the incorrect one. Lead oxide is getting reduced. That's the right one. Look at this. I wrote it down. Carbon is getting oxidized. That's also right one. I wrote it over there. Lead oxidized is getting reduced. 1 and 3 are already opposite of each other. Only one is right. And that's one definitely. This is the incorrect statement. Lead is getting reduced. No, lead is getting oxidized to lead oxide, if that was possible. So that's also incorrect statement. 3 and 4 incorrect statement. Where do you see that? Let me know your response. I'll see. I hope you got it. And done. Okay, what answer did you get? For me, this is the answer. Is it matching with your answer? Hopefully, yeah. This is the right answer. Third and fourth are the incorrect statement. Okay, students, let's move to next question. Could be a one marker question. Why a combustion reaction is an oxidation reaction? Because whenever I try to burn a substance, we need oxygen. Okay, and oxygen react with your fuel and try to oxidize itself and give energy. A very important example, in our household we burn LPG gas, right? And that's nothing but butane gas. I hope you're very, very well aware of the same, because in chapter number 4, carbon is compound, we somehow know about this 4 carbon alkane formula CnH2n plus 2. That's butane, and we generally going to have the butane gas and LPG whenever you try to burn. What will happen? They'll take atmospheric oxygen that's necessary to burn a substance, and what it will give you? CO2, carbon getting oxidized, hydrogen getting oxidized, and definitely energy, heat energy, so that we will use it in terms of making our food and doing whatever we want. Yeah. So why combustion reaction is an oxidation reaction? Because to burn a substance, we need oxygen. That's how a reaction will proceed. You can prove your point with the help of chemistry equations, because that will prove that you have sufficient knowledge for the same. Yeah. Okay. I hope you got it. Give me a high five. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Oil and fat containing food items are flushed with nitrogen. Why? Very easy question. When I talk about oil and fat containing food, these are very much prone to oxidation. And when they get oxidized, what will happen, students? Do let me know. I'll wait. Yeah? What will happen? Waiting. And yes, oxidize. What will happen if they'll oxidize? They give a very foul smell and a bad taste too. And what are we going to call it? That the food will become rancid. Okay? When we'll flush with nitrogen means, we in the packet of something, we'll remove the oxygen and we'll put nitrogen gas, because nitrogen is kind of a non-reactive gas and will not react with your oil and fat inside your food and will not make it rancid. So your food will last longer. That's the reason. We'll prevent it a bit from rancidity. Yes. So you will see the detailed answer over there, though I have explained each and every point in detail, because your Anubha ma'am believes that my students will understand each and every point. Their basic must be super clear, and they can proudly say that now whatever type of question will come, I know the concept and I can solve it. I won't say this question is out of syllabus, because that generally doesn't happen. Identify the substance oxidized and reduced in the reaction. Okay, let's just see that. First of all, what kind of a reaction is this? You can clearly see zinc is displacing copper, being more reactive and giving you zinc oxide in copper. So that's definitely a displacement reaction. That's definitely a displacement reaction. But apart from that, that's also a redox reaction. Reduction oxidation is taking place simultaneously. How come? Let me take another color, and until then you can always send your response. That's how revision will be done, right? So let's see that. My copper oxide, tell me, is converting to copper. Loss of oxygen. Oxidation. Look at this. Zinc converting to zinc oxide. Gain of oxygen. Loss of oxygen. Reduction. Yeah. Galti se mistake. It can happen from mom's side too. Zinc is converting to zinc oxide. Gain of oxygen. Oxidation. Color is not visible clearly. I'll write it down there. Substance that's getting oxidized is zinc. Zinc is getting oxidized to zinc oxide. The substance that's going to reduce is copper oxide, because that's reduced to copper. Yeah, everyone. So this is what you needed to tell, and that's super super easy, not at all difficult, I must say. Yes, everyone. And that's how, this is just a trailer. Students, Vedantu platform is like very vast, and you know, so versatile that you'll be able to see so much detail of everything. 100% knowledge you can get, 100% marks as well, because every session will have unlimited, you'll be able to have unlimited live classes. Every session will have fun and live quizzes as well. Even if you'll see replay, you can attempt quizzes in that replay also, and you'll see such a live kind of experience, and you can compete with the students throughout the world, and a healthy competition, I must say. And leaderboard, you'll see your name if you'll do good, and we'll give you real-time analysis how well you're doing. You can download the notes every time with the teacher's feedback. In class doubt solving with the help of master teachers and class teachers, you'll be able to interact with them. There will be a Q&A panel where you can ask your questions, and that will be solved. 5,000 plus micro courses, you name a chapter, and even more than that, you'll see a variety of courses. Even you can attend a chapter session so many times until there will be no knowledge gap and all of your doubts will be solved. Free crash courses for competitive exams, for your board exams as well. So this is the best time, because if you'll go for 3 months, your proper revision and guaranteed score booster will be there. Yeah. And even right now, if you're confused, I'm at 70, 75, 90% possible. True, it's possible. Okay, students, so less is more for Vedantu, because here you'll pay very less and can attend unlimited live sessions. Link in the description box. The coupon code is AGEPRO, because that will give you the discount. That's 20% for 1 month, and 3 months, it will be 31%. So if you'll apply AGEPRO code 2699, no, you have to pay just 2159. And for 3 months, you will just have to pay 1800 and something, 1833 or 1866, something like that, for 3 months. And it's just paying, you know, 11 to 9 rupees per session, depending upon the time duration that you're going to choose. So isn't it great? You know everything about this. On this note, I'll move ahead. Would love to see you in my classes as well. Okay, let's see the another question. A shiny brown color substance X on heating in air become black in color. It's a very famous and important question. So shiny brown color, generally metal we have is copper, because whenever you try to burn it or you try to heat it in air, what will happen? A copper oxide layer will form on the surface, which is of black color. So that problem is solved. This is your X. Name the element X and the black color compound form. It's clear. You can balance the reaction as well, because whenever you try to write the reaction, please write it into balanced chemical equation form. That will give you more clarity that you know about the same. Okay, Panda, is super duper clear? Yeah. Okay, everyone. Okay, let's move to the next one. Again, very easy. Define rusting. Why do we apply paint on the iron article? So what exactly is rusting, everyone? Rusting generally is a term we use for iron. So this is nothing but corrosion of iron, right? And what exactly is that? My iron metal getting eaten up with the attack of the moisture on the surface, and it's a continuous process, and there will be a degradation of metal that will occur. And finally, because of the same, we are having very much loss to our economy every year. Yeah, so that's rusting. And the formula that the product that's going to form on the iron surface is hydrated iron oxide, hydrated ferric oxide. In the first question, I told you, reddish brown color substance. And why do we apply paint on iron articles? Because of the same, to prevent it from rusting, to prevent it from corrosion. Because when you apply the layer of paint, what will happen? That act as a protective layer so that the moisture won't able to come in contact with my iron article and will stay for a longer time without getting rusted. Yeah, everyone, not at all difficult. Yeah, I know you know it. And I hope you're writing it down. I hope you are revising here and giving your best. That, yeah, ma'am, I'll try to tell you. I'll try to think in my mind and will, you know, say that, yeah, this is the answer. And that's how I will write it into exam. Because more and more practice in terms of speaking and telling, that will give you more clarity and definitely score boosting for you guys. Okay, let's move to next question. This question is also very much important. So yeah, that's why we call this series as VIP. Very, very important questions we'll discuss. Okay, so we need to tell about a substance getting oxidized, reduce an oxidizing agent, reducing agent. Just look at this. My MnO2 is converting to MnCl2. That's how we need to see it from reactant to product side. MnO2 to Cl, MnCl2, that means loss of oxygen. And loss of oxygen is nothing but reduction. That means I will write that my MnO2 is getting reduced. And please do remember that if a substance get reduced, that means it will do oxidation of other substance and will act as an OA, oxidizing agent. It will do the oxidation of other substance. How? By providing its oxygen. Okay, loss of oxygen itself getting reduced. Other substance will take oxygen, oxidize. So MnO2 here is acting as oxidizing agent. When I see HCl, it's converting to HCl, and we'll see loss of hydrogen, and loss of hydrogen is oxidation. Gain of hydrogen is reduction. Loss of hydrogen is oxidation. So here my HCl is getting oxidized, and if a substance get oxidized, that will does reduction of other, that will give hydrogen to other, and other will take hydrogen, means getting reduced. That's an RA, that's a reducing agent. All right. So HCl is a reducing agent, get oxidized. This is reduced and OA. Some ask, ma'am, why not HCl2H2O? Because students, when I see that, basically we need to keep hydrogen in our mind. Hydrogen in both of the reactant and product side is just same. That means I'm talking about their charge and valency. Hydrogen carry plus one charge in the compound in general, if coming in very starting, and will be same. And when you move to 11th class, you'll get to know about a concept that whenever a charge will remain same on the product side too, that will neither oxidize and reduce. And you'll get to know about this very famous line that I use in the class, Leo goes to Gr. What does that mean? Loss of electron is oxidation. Loss of electron from a substance is oxidation. Gain of electron from a substance is reduction. So if a charge remains same, means no loss, no gain, that won't oxidize and reduce. So we won't see in terms of hydrogen, but in terms of chlorine here. Okay, so that was the reason. Chlorine was in the compound form, chlorine in the free form, elemental form, chlorine doesn't have any charge, zero. And here compound, minus one, plus one and minus one. Minus one to zero is possible if I add plus one into the same. That means my chlorine here is taking an electron. If it will get rid of this electron, it will carry no charge. So loss of electron, that's oxidation. So my chlorine basically here is getting oxidized. So you got the point. You will understand that in detail in higher classes. You do not need to write this much information in your board exams. Okay. Whatever I told in very starting will work. Okay. Let's have this question. Asha has been collecting silver coins and copper coins. Silver coins and copper coins. One day she observed a black coating on silver coins and green coating on copper coins. Okay, definitely that will happen. And now I'll tell you what exactly is the reason for the same. That's what they're asking, which chemical phenomena? That's nothing but corrosion. How come when silver get reacted with the atmospheric gas, that's hydrogen sulfide mainly, will be very much in high amount in that air, which is more of like near sewage. Okay, so that is like sulfur content is very high over there. So that will react with silver sulfide, hydrogen sulfide, to give silver sulfide and hydrogen gas. That's of black in color. That's why silver will develop a black coating. That will happen to ma'am when I used to live in Delhi, GTB Nagar. There was a very big sewage over there. Those students who are from Delhi knows it very well. And then whenever I used to keep my jewelry outside, like silver one, and after even in 2-3 days, I just forgot one time, and when I observed it, I had a ring. It was like all black, blackish color layer. Okay, when I talk about copper, what's the copper corrosion? It will react with moisture, that means my oxygen and water vapors, along with carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, to give a mixture of copper carbonate with CO3 copper carbonate and copper hydroxide with the same. And this kind of a mixture is having a green color, so that's why they develop a green color coating. Yeah, write the chemical name of black and green coating. So you'll say this is silver sulfide. This is, you can also say basic copper carbonate. Hydroxide is responsible for basic behavior, right? You can also call it basic copper carbonate. This will work, right everyone? And this is very easy. So this topic is very clear. I must say super duper clear. And I am very much sure now this question is easy peasy for you guys. No? Because we talked about the same. The substance that are oxidized and the substance that are going to reduce. Do we have to think twice? Not at all. Sodium to sodium oxide, that's gain of oxygen, and gain of oxygen is always oxidation. So sodium get oxidized to Na2. O2 is converting to O here, means O2 to O means that's a kind of loss of oxygen. So definitely reduction. So my O2 is getting reduced here. My sodium is getting oxidized here. Agreed? Yes, thumbs up? Sure. Very good. Copper oxide to copper, loss of oxygen. Hydrogen to H2O, gain of oxygen. Loss of oxygen is oxidation, means copper oxide is getting oxidized. Loss of oxygen is actually reduction, okay? And gain of oxygen is oxidation. So the conclusion here is copper oxide getting reduced, hydrogen getting oxidized. Yes, everyone, got it? Hopefully, isn't it like very easy now? I hope you have seen all the classes that ma'am had taken on this or the other platform of 9-10 Hindi channel. All the topic are completed with now most important questions. Also, Sprintex series, which is going on 9-10 Hindi channel. If you follow these three things, I'm pretty much sure no one can take your 90% at all. You'll definitely score above that. Yes, everyone. So this is something, again, just for all the newcomers, that if you also want to score 100%, attend unlimited live classes, active learning, and competition throughout the world. The healthy one can analyze your performance throughout the class, how you are getting better and better each and every time. Interactive replays where you can take participation in all the live quizzes. You will come in leaderboard as well. You can download the notes in class, doubt solving with the help of master teachers and class teachers. Unlimited micro courses, 5,000 and plus, and you can attend unlimited live classes according to your requirement. Crash courses as well for the further revision. So less is more, because here at Vedantu, if you check your description box link, copy it, just go through it, apply the code ADE Pro, you can take 1 or 3 months courses. We'll get 20 and 31% extra discount if you'll apply ADE Pro code, because now you have to pay 2159 for a month. For 3 months, 5599. Just divided it by 3, you'll get 18 something something. Yeah. So you'll see that how accessible it is, like paying 11 or 9 rupees per session. So choose it wisely and do let me know. And Anubha ma'am is there on Instagram, finally with Vedantu handle. You can follow me at chemistry.vedantu_Anubha Gaur for so many updates. And students, I must say that this is it for today. I hope revision is going awesome because this chapter is over. I'll come up with the next session very soon with the next chapter. Until then, need your support. Do not forget to like. Do not forget to share it with your friends. And definitely, if you're new, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and we'll make sure to help you with our best possible ways. Thank you so much for today. We'll come next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye. Happy learning.